So any code, a linear block code will generally take k input bits and produce n output bits. Using mod 2 matrix arithmetic. So we will usually call the k input bits are the information bits. So I have a message that's encoded in k bits. That's my information, and that's what I want to send to the other side. So basically, I'm going to transform that somehow into my code. So my n output bits, we call these. We've already said this. This is the code. So usually, actually always, n is greater than k, and n minus k, the difference between those two, we call those parity bits. And the reason is, we're using mod 2 arithmetic to generate the code word, and therefore, these n minus k bits are generated using mod 2 additions, we call them parity bits. Okay, we use mod 2 matrix arithmetic. So basically what we do is we have two matrices. G and H. So G is called the generator. The generator matrix. H is called the parity check matrix. So G is used in encoding. G takes k input bits and produces n output bits. And H is used in decoding in a way that we'll talk about probably next class. But first let's look at encoding. So we have generator matrix G. G is a k rows by n columns matrix, and the entries in G are all 0 or 1. And that's a requirement because we're going to use mod 2 arithmetic over this matrix. So what we do is our information bits are contained in a 1 by k row vector. So let's call that m1, m2, mk, where all the m's are binary. And what we're going to do actually, let's call this vector m. M for message, so m is the message that I want to send. And then what I do is I form my code word C by taking m times g, where m is multiplied on the left by g. And everything, just bear in mind, everything here is mod 2. So, example. So let's let G be equal to, let's let, excuse me, K equals 2 and N equals 3. And let's let G be equal to this, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So, if I have a message, how long is my message?
2
bits, because k is 2. So let's say I want to send the message 0, 0. And I want to send that as a code word. Or I multiply these two to get my code word. So what is that? 0, 0. That's 1, 0. That's just 0. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So the all zero code word. See another example, let's say 1, 1. 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay. 1, 1 times 1, 0. What's that? 1 times 1 plus 1 times 0. Okay, a couple things to notice about this. First off, what code is this generating? So think about the operations here. Actually, I'll make the first remark first. So remark, G contains an identity submatrix. So G is this. This here is the identity matrix. So therefore, MG is equal to M times an identity submatrix. I'll say that's I2 for the size 2 identity matrix. And the rest of this, I'm going to call P. So the resulting vector is MI2. The first two elements are M times I2, and the last element is M times P. And M times the identity matrix is just M. So what we have is that the message bits are always repeated on the output as the first two bits. So in fact, you can see that. 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. So what's the last, what's going on with P? You can think of this as the parity check part of the generator. So if I have 1, 1, M times 1, 1 is doing what? It's basically taking the mod 2 sum of all of the bits in M. And what code does that generate? Single parity check. So this is the single parity check code. So that's neat. It turns out the single parity check code is a linear block code.